In this video, we can use a King property to evaluate these two integrals. They are from college math computation. So first, let's write down the King property. So King property is just the integral from a to b of f of x dx. That equals the integral from a to b of f of a plus b minus x dx. So King property is one of the techniques we use to evaluate the integrals. So now let's see how to use the King property to evaluate the first one. So first, we can use I for the integral. So now let's start from here. Okay, we use I for this integral. Just from a to b, then f of x. Then for the first question, just this integral. And here we have just integral from 0 to pi over 2, the top, just here sine x. The bottom here is the sine, so this cosine. So then we label this one as the result one. Okay, so now we can use the King property. Because this integral is I equals this one. Okay, so now let's write down. So for this integral, we can write it as the second way. So here from A to B, so then I'm going to use this one. So then here, just f of A plus B minus x dx. Then what is A here? So this A is a B. Okay, so that's why here we have a equals 0, then b equals pi over 2. So then here just 0 plus pi over 2 minus x, so that's why, so here just pi over 2 minus x. So we have to use a pi over 2 minus x to replace all the x's here. Okay, so then we have the following. So then here just from 0 to pi over 2. So then here, from 0 to pi over 2. Then on top, so here just a sine, here pi over 2 minus x. Then on the bottom, so this one, just here, just sine pi over 2 minus x. Then here, the next one is cosine. Cosine pi over 2 minus x. Then here, dx. Okay, so then simplify using the trig identity. Because it's a trig identity, let's see on top. Sine pi over 2 minus x equals cosine x. Then here, the first one is also cosine x. So let's see the second one. So second one here, cosine pi over 2 minus x equals sine x. Here. So now you see we got I also equals this integral. So then we're going to label this one as result 2. So now we're going to do result 1 plus result 2. You see here, so result 1, just I equals the original integral. So now result 2, I equals the new one. So now adding together means the left-hand side, that's just I plus I, that's 2I. So the right-hand side, so the original integral plus this one. So that's why here we have then the left-hand side is so 2i. So the right-hand side, first write down the original integral. That's a pi over 2. Then here just square root sine x. Then the bottom here, just square root sine x plus cosine x dx. So then plus the one we just got, this one. Okay, so then plus the result 2. from 0 to pi over 2, then this one on top, that's cosine. Cosine x, bottom here, so square root cosine x, then here, square root sine x, then dx. Okay, so because they have the same denominator, so we can combine them together. Okay, so then combine them together, we have, so on top, square root sine x, here, square root cosine x. Then the bottom, they have the same thing. Then here, just sine x, cosine x, then dx. So you see the top and bottom, they have the exact same thing. So then they canceled. So then the inside function just one. So then here we have just dx. So then just equals pi over 2. So now you see 2i equals pi over 2. So that means I equals pi over 4. So that is the answer for the first integral. Okay, so now let's do the second question. Okay, so again, do the same thing, it's a King property. So now let's see the second question. So again, we start from I just from A to, so this is the end of first one, okay. So then I from, integral from A to B of f of x. So then this refer to the second integral. So that's from 0 to pi over 2, then the inside is 1 over 1 plus tangent to the power 23, here x, dx. Okay, again, we label this one as a result 1. Okay, so then we're going to use the King property. So then, based on the King property, so this integral also equals this one. So equals f of a plus b minus x dx. Again, a here, that is 0. B, that's a pi over 2. So that's why the inside just pi over 2 minus x. So then we're going to use pi over 2 minus x, replace x here. Okay, so then here we have from 0 to pi over 2. Then on top is 1, on the bottom, so here 1 plus, so this is a tangent, then here pi over 2 minus x, then the power 23. This, let's simplify. So let's simplify the bottom. So let's see the top. So the bottom, based on the trig identity, so tangent pi over 2 minus x equals cotangent. So that's why here, just cotangent. Cotangent x. Then here, the power 23. So next, we want to change cotangent to tangent. So then here, because cotangent equals 1 over tangent. Okay, so that's why cotangent equals 1 over tangent. So here, tangent, then x. So the power 23, then here, dx. Okay, so then let's simplify. So let's simplify. So then here we have, then top is a tangent x to the power 23. Then on the bottom, just tangent, here just x, then plus 1, dx. Okay, so then we can label this one as a result 2. So then here we have the integral I equals this integral. So now we're going to do the result 1 plus result 2. Okay, because the result 2 is I equals this new integral. So then result 1, just the original integral, I equals the original question. So adding them together, so left hand side is 2i, so right hand side, so original integral plus this one. Okay, so then here we have, so 2i. So here we have 2i equals the original integral. So here from 0 to pi over 2, then here 1 over 1 plus tangent. So here 20/23 of x, then plus this one. Okay, so plus this one here, just from 0 to pi over 2, then on top. So tangent 20/23 of x, then the bottom here, just tangent 20/23 x plus 1, then dx. Okay, so just a 1 plus 2, result 1 plus result 2. So then they have the same denominator. So let's combine them together. Here, so on top, that is 1 plus tangent 20/23 x. On the bottom, they have the same denominator. 20/23 x dx. So they have the same numerator and denominator. So cancel out, so we have here just dx. So then just equals pi over 2. So we have 2i equals pi over 2. So then I equals pi over 4. So that is the answer for the second integral. Okay, so now let's have a quick proof to the King property. Okay, so let's prove. So this is the end of the second integral. So let's prove. So the King property, so from a to b, f of x, dx. Okay, so then let's do the substitution. So we're gonna let the u equals a plus b minus x. So then we solve for x, x equals a plus b minus u. So then let's do the dx. So then we have dx equals negative du. Then what is the lower limit, upper limit for u? So now let's see. So when x equals a, the lower limit. So then u put here, a put here, so u equals b. Then when x equals b, put here, that is a. So that's why when x equals b, so u equals a. Okay, so now let's do the substitution. Let's put the equal sign, continue here. So then here we have, do the substitution. So the lower limit, that's a b. Upper limit, that's a. So the inside f of x, here is x. So here just a plus b minus u, then here dx negative du. Okay, so then here, let's swap the lower limit and with upper limit. So here we have negative sign. So then here just from a to b, then here just a plus b minus u, then du. So next, so let's use x for u. So then here we have, so from a to b, so here f of a plus b minus here x, then dx. So now we'll just prove the King property. Thanks for watching. See you next time.